welcome to the special edition of Rajya Sabha Television Question Hour. I'm Kriti Mishra, and joining me is my colleague Vishal Dahiya.
Well, thank you, Kriti. And this is the episode wherein we bring you the questions which have been asked by the members of parliament during the monsoon session and the answers given by the government to those questions. So let's begin, Kriti, with the first question.
So the first question was asked by Dr. Sanjay Singh, P. Bhattacharya, and they've asked about the steps taken by the government to stop incidents of suicides by farmers.
Well, the answer has been given by Minister of State for Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, Purushottam Rupala here, and he goes on to say that agriculture is a state subject. Agrarian distress can be addressed by enabling the farmers to increase their income. Now, the government is targeting to double the income of the farmers by year 2022. The department has therefore been implementing various schemes to meet this objective, like soil health card, neem-coated urea, Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sichai Yojana, National Agriculture Market Scheme, Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana, Interest Subvention Scheme, etc. Further, in the budget for 2018-2019, the government had announced that MSP for all unannounced kharif crops will be 1.5 times the cost of production, giving a major boost for the farmers' income. The Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs later has approved the increase in MSPs for all kharif crops for 2018-2019 season at a level of at least 150% of the cost of production. So clearly this goes on to detail the steps which have been taken by the government in increasing the farmers' income. Well, the next one, Kriti, is from Narayan Lal Pancharya, who goes on to ask the government whether it has conducted any study into the efficacy of e-mandis in augmenting income of farmers.
Well, Vishal, the answer has been given by MOS Agriculture, Mr. Gajendra Singh Shekhawat, and he says that National Agriculture Market Scheme was launched on 14th of April 2016 with an objective of facilitating better and real-time price discovery for the farmers for their produce through competitive online transparent auction process. This also aims at providing with pricing commensurate with quality of produce of farmers. As per target, 585 wholesale regulated markets across the country have been integrated with eNAM platform by 31st of March 2018. The government is also incentivizing the development of marketing infrastructure to make the agricultural marketing efficient through schemes of agricultural marketing infrastructure. So that's a very important answer, Vishal, as far as the farming community is concerned.
Yes, indeed.
In fact, Agriculture Minister Radha Mohan Singh informed the Rajya Sabha while answering one of the oral questions on the floor of the House that farmer suicide has declined in 2016. He said that agrarian distress can be addressed by enabling the farmers to increase their income, and that the government has also launched several steps in that direction. Listen in.
निश्चित रूप से देश में किसानों के द्वारा आत्महत्या ये चिंता का विषय है, लेकिन राज्य सरकार के सहयोग से मोदी सरकार ने जो नई नई योजनाएं चलाई है किसानों के सशक्तिकरण के लिए, जो आंकड़े जो 16 के आए हैं वो निश्चित रूप से उसमें कमी आ रही है. किसानों के सशक्तिकरण के लिए हमारी सरकार ने, आप देखेंगे, पांचवा बजट आया है. हमारी सरकार आने के 5 वर्ष पहले का किसानों के सशक्तिकरण की बात है. इसमें उसमें 1,21,000 करोड़ का बजट था, और हमारा 5 वर्ष का जो बजट आप देखेंगे, पांचवा बजट, तो 2,11,000 करोड़ का हमने निवेश किया है. और इतना ही नहीं, तो बजटीय निवेश के अलावा भी हमने कॉर्पस फंड बनाए. 99 परियोजनाएं जो लंबित पड़ी थी, पैसे के अभाव में लंबित पड़ा था. इस सरकार ने कॉर्पस फंड की व्यवस्था की है, और 19 तक वो 99 परियोजनाएं पूरी होने जा रही है, जो 20-30 वर्ष से लंबित था. और इसी तरह से माइक्रो इरिगेशन के लिए अलग से कॉर्पस फंड बनाया है, डेयरी प्रोसेसिंग एंड इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर डेवलपमेंट के लिए अलग से 10,000 करोड़ का बनाया है.
मैंने
पूरा निवेश हम किसानों के सशक्तिकरण में कर रहे हैं.
Well, there's been another supplementary which has been asked by BJP's Vijaypal Tomar on this, Kriti, and he goes on to ask the Agriculture Minister about the steps and schemes taken by the government to improve farmers' income. Let's listen in Vijaypal Tomar's question.
किसान के स्वावलंबी बनाने के लिए, जैसा भी उन्होंने कहा, soil health card कितने लोगों तक पहुंच गया, क्या हर गांव तक पहुंचेगा, क्या-क्या कदम उठा रहे हैं?
Responding to supplementary question, Radha Mohan Singh, who's the agriculture minister, said that the government has increased the budgetary allocation to the agriculture sector. He also said that government had taken up various schemes and initiatives to double farm income, such as integrated farming, agroforestry, deep fishing, vocal mission and organic farming. Take a listen.
हम जब आए थे तो चार साल के अंदर 45 लैब देश भर में थे. आज चार साल के अंदर 9,243 या 45 लैब देश के अंदर स्थापित हो गए हैं. और सॉयल हेल्थ कार्ड बनाने के लिए एक पैसा राज्यों को नहीं जाता था, तो वो पैसा दिया है और प्रथम चरण में 10 करोड़ से ज्यादा और दूसरे चरण में भी अब शुरू हुआ है और पोर्टल पर ला रहे हैं. किसानों में इसमें जागरूकता आवे उसके लिए भी अलग से बजटीय प्रावधान किया है.
धन्यवाद.
राज्य सरकारें भी बड़ी तेजी से किसानों को इस दिशा में जागरूक
बनाने के लिए काम कर रहे
हैं. मूविंग ऑन टू द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ टेलीकॉम नाउ विशाल. सो एके सर्वराज हैज आस्क्ड वेदर इट इज अ फैक्ट दैट गवर्नमेंट विल डिजिटाइज 700 विलेजेस इन द कंट्री अंडर इट्स डिजी-गांव प्रोग्राम बाय द एंड ऑफ ईयर.
Well, and the Minister Manoj Sinha has answered this by saying that the Government of India under the Digital India program has envisaged the Digital Village project to provide various government to citizen services and other associated services to citizens, especially living in the rural areas. Till May 2018, there were 2,95,486 common services centers functioning across the country, among which 2,10,314 CSCs are at Gram Panchayat level. Now, the CSCs function on a service delivery or transaction-oriented self-sustainable entrepreneurship model with the objective to enable non-discriminatory access to e-services to citizens, especially in rural areas. Well, the next one, Kriti, is from the member Satyanarayan Jethia, who goes on to ask the Communications Minister about the effective measures taken to improve the quality of telecommunication services of all the mobile companies associated with the Ministry of Communications.
So, Telecom Minister Manoj Sinha says that the government is making available sufficient spectrum for mobile services, including auction of 965 megahertz in 2016, allowing spectrum sharing, trading and liberalization of allocated spectrum as per the guidelines to facilitate efficient utilization, permitting sharing of active as well as passive infrastructure by the telecom service providers, and also expansion of mobile networks and related improvements are carried out by the telecom service providers. Moving on to the Ministry of Railways now, Vishal.
Yes.
And in one of the start questions, Majid Menon asked the Railways Minister about efforts by the government to improve railways and if it is planning to replace bio toilets with vacuum bio toilets.
But it appears from the record that, as I have asked it, whether it's a fact that the railways are planning to replace bio toilets with vacuum bio toilets at the cost of 1 lakh rupees per toilet. And if you make such changes in thousands of coaches, then the cost would go into crores. And of course, it's the taxpayers' money.
Well, Kriti, in his answer, the Railway Minister Piyush Goyal has replied that the Railways proposes to complete the work of installation of bio toilets in all train coaches by 2019. He said that bio toilets in trains will be odor-free, cut down water usage by 1/20th and will have much lesser chances of getting blocked. Goyal also said that the Indian Railways will introduce bio toilets in all coaches by next year. Let's listen to the full answer.
The fact is that the Railways has decided that the entire rail network, all the trains, passenger, express, Durantos, Rajdhanis, unreserved also, second class unreserved, all toilets will be replaced with bio toilets. We have already completed it in almost 60% of the coaches. The balance is in fast progress, fast speed. And by next year, it will be 100% bio toilets in the railways, completely eliminating the defecation going onto the tracks, which was not only unhygienic, not only bad for sanitation and cleanliness, but also it was affecting the railway safety because the uric acid going into the on the tracks was damaging the tracks and causing accidents. We are completely eliminating that. Some complaints, sir, were received that there's a backlash smell which comes out from the vacuum toilet. That happens particularly if anybody puts any garbage into the vacuum, into the bio toilet, my apologies. If anybody puts any garbage in the bio toilet, it clogs the bio toilet. And since the material of defecation is inside the toilet and is biodigestively processed, it gives a backlash of foul smell. Therefore, we are experimenting. We have ordered, we are in the process of ordering, the tender will open on 26th or 27th July. We are in the process of finding a way to get vacuum system retrofitted on the biotoil.
Well, Kriti, in a supplementary to this question, Ravi Prakash Verma has asked another one, wherein he says that the government's decision to install biodigester tanks beneath all train coaches for the collection of human fecal matter is not fully implemented.
Biodigester lagane ka decision liya tha. Sir, aaj bhi hazaron trainein chal rahi hain, jisme sab mein lagaya nahi gaya. Aur aaj bhi fecal matter sab patriyon pe girta hai. तो मैं जानना ये चाह रहा था क्या रेलवेज ने कोई स्टडी कराया है कि कितना मीथेन जनरेशन इस अकाउंट में हो रहा है जो फेकल मैटर सड़कों ये पटरी के ऊपर गिरता है और क्या आपको लगता है कि इमीडिएटली बायोडाइजेस्टर फिट करने से उसमें कुछ बचत हो पाएगा.
Well, Rail Minister Piyush Goyal assured the House that the work to install biodigester tanks is in full force and tanks would be installed very soon. Here's the answer.
Biodigester ya bio toilet fit hone ke baad jo niche girta tha mal wo band hoga to puri tarike se railway ke system ko bhi surakshit rakhega aur sath hi sath wo jo foul smell ki aapne charcha ki methane ki wo bhi khatam hoga. Isliye to hum itne bade paimane pe इसको तेज गति से लगा रहे हैं. आप भी जानते हैं कि इस सरकार ने मेक इन इंडिया प्रोग्राम को बल दिया है, प्रोत्साहन दिए, इसलिए हम इसको विदेश से लाने के बदले डीआरडीओ की सहायता से, डिफेंस रिसर्च डेवलपमेंट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन की सहायता से इसको भारत में ही बनाया गया, डेवलप किया गया और भारतीय कंपनियों की जो क्षमता है उस स्पेस में हम इसको बदल पा रहे हैं. अगले 12-18 महीने में ये पूरी तरीके से भारत की रेलवे में बायोडाइजेस्टर लग जाए. मीथेन गैस कितना निकलता है वो तो अलग अलग टॉयलेट में कितने लोग ट्रैवल कर रहे हैं, किस गाड़ी में कितने हैं उसके ऊपर होगा, लेकिन निकलता है ये वास्तविकता है. इसको बैठ के असेस करना लगभग असंभव की तरह है, पर ये समस्या का हल निकालने पे हमने ज्यादा फोकस किया.
In another question, Vishal, MP Vijay Sai Reddy asked the minister about the cost of the bio toilets in the rail coaches. Here's the question.
I would like to know from the Honorable Minister, what is the additional cost to the exchequer? Of course, vacuum system is being added. What exactly is the loss that is incurred to the exchequer on account of change in the policy?
Right.
Well, in the answer, the Minister has said that bio toilets cost has fallen down and the government is committed to spend any money to ensure passenger safety.
The bio toilet cost has drastically fallen from what it was 4 or 5 years ago. Current levels are about 1 lakh rupees per bio toilet. I'm hoping with reverse auction it may come down further. As regards this government's policy, Honorable Chairman Sir, we do not believe passenger service and passenger safety can be calculated by any cost. We are willing to spend any amount of money if it comes to passenger safety and passenger service. And this particular work of bio toilets is for both. As I said, the tracks are protected because of uric acid and damage to tracks. It expands the life of the tracks, makes it safer, less accidents, and it makes the passenger experience better.
Well, Kriti, let's take a short break here, but when we come back, we will give you other questions from ministries like information technology and chemicals and fertilizers. Stay tuned.
Art arisen from a multi-hued cultural canvas. Tradition and cultural fervor dating back centuries. And encircling them all, there's a magic that awes. Embrace your nation's brilliant human warmth. Watch Colors of India, Sundays at 9:30 p.m. on Rajya Sabha Television. Thank you.
back. You're watching Question R.
Well, this time around, let's move on to the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. And herein, Vinay Sahastrabudhi has asked a question about the security measures on Aadhaar and whether the government is planning on spreading awareness about security of Aadhaar.
ये आधार के बारे में इतनी कोशिश उस विभाग की और सरकार की होने के बावजूद भी आधार की पूरी व्यवस्था को बहुत गलत तरीके से कभी-कभी मीडिया में प्रस्तुत किया जाता है, बदनामी होती है। तो इसमें शिक्षकों, प्राध्यापकों, समाजसेवियों, आंगनवाड़ी कार्यकर्ताओं, इनके माध्यम से जनजागरण के प्रयास के बारे में क्या सरकार कुछ सोच रही
है? Replying to the query, IT Minister Ravishankar Prasad assured the House that Aadhaar contains robust security measures and protects privacy.
मैं उनकी चिंता के साथ अपने को जोड़ते हुए एक ही बात कहना चाहूंगा, आधार की उपयोगिता उसके काम से आनी चाहिए। और जिस तरह मैंने बताया कि 130 और मैं कहता हूं, मैंने पहले भी कहा था कि आधार शुरू किया उन लोगों ने, बाद में हमने उसको कानूनी जामा पहनाया प्राइवेसी की चिंता की। आज आधार पर वर्ल्ड बैंक, IMF सबों ने कहा इट इज अ फाइन इंस्ट्रूमेंट ऑफ गवर्नेंस एंड ऑल्सो ऑफ डिलीवरी। ये बात मुझे सही लगती है कि जहां आधार की लोकप्रियता बढ़ी है, इसकी स्वीकार्यता बढ़ी है, इसके बारे में और जागरूकता पैदा करने की जरूरत है। हमारे विभाग की ओर से काम होता है, हमारे CSC वगैरह काम करते हैं इसमें। अगर माननीय सदस्य का और कोई सुझाव होगा तो मैं जरूर उस पर ध्यान रखूंगा।
Another important question was asked by MP Kanimoy and she asked about the regulation of data collection for Aadhaar and steps about data protection as many companies share users' data without their prior permission.
There are multiple technology firms that are collecting data from the individuals and are doing so without explicit consent of the individuals. How will the government ensure that collection of data by technology firms and their usage will be regulated and data privacy under the ambit of right to life and personal liberty be protected?
Well, this one also, Kriti, has been answered by the Union Minister Ravishankar Prasad, who said the government abides by the right to privacy. But as India is fast emerging as a digital power in the world, pragmatic blend of the two is a must. He also said that the government counsels the consumers to not give consent to share important information. Let's listen in to the minister.
I want to assure this house, as I have said in the reply itself, that in the leadership of Justice Krishna, a very retired eminent judge of the Supreme Court, data protection work is going on. They have undertaken consultation process and the report, I believe, will come shortly. Thereafter, considering which, we may move to the parliament as per the prescribed procedure. But sir, the larger issue is, sir, the honourable member is right. One is the issue of privacy, one the issue of emergence of digital power. And we must have a pragmatic blend of the two. For instance, in India, we did not go to the debate of net neutrality. We said right of access is not compromisable. And today India is emerging as a digital power. About privacy, which you have alluded to, I cannot call upon the committee's report unless the report comes. But sir, one thing I must tell you, that while we completely acknowledge the right of privacy the Supreme Court has laid down under Article 21, privacy cannot become the plea of the terrorist and the corrupt. This will have to acknowledge. And therefore, a practical, pragmatic view has to be taken. And secondly, while respecting the mandate of right of privacy, India is emerging as a big innovative power in the digital field. That also shouldn't be compromised.
Let's now move on to the Ministry of Chemicals and Fertilizers. And herein, Sanjay Raut has asked a question about pharmaceutical sector's regulator, the National Pharmaceutical Pricing Authority, analyzing the bills of some hospitals and concluding that doctors and hospitals prefer prescribing branded drugs which are not under drug price control.
The answer has been given by MOS Chemicals and Fertilizers, Mansukh Lal Mandavia, and he says that based on complaints and media reports on overpricing and inflated bills to the patient by some hospitals, National Pharmaceutical Pharmacing Authority had asked for details of billing from these hospitals. NPPA is effectively monitoring the prices of scheduled as well as non-scheduled medicines. It takes action against companies found overcharging the consumers based on the references received from the state drugs controllers, individuals and samples purchased from the open market. Reports from market-based data and complaints reported through the grievance redressal websites, Pharma Jan Samadhan and centralized public grievance redress and monitoring system.
Well, that indeed is a detailed answer to that question there, Kriti.
Absolutely, Vishal. Now, moving on to the Ministry of Food Processing. KC Ramamurthy of the Congress raised the issue of lack of storage facilities of agricultural produce for food processing industry.
As per some estimates,
only 2% of agriculture produce is estimated to be preserved for processing in our country due to lack of storage facilities when compared to United States, where 70% of the agricultural produce is processed. I would like to know from the Honorable Minister, under Pradhan Mantri Kisan Sampad Yojana, you have mentioned that 6,000 crores is allotted for 2016-20 period, and 2016-17 is already over, 17-18 is already over. Can I know the progress achieved in each of the schemes, particularly with reference to infrastructure for the food processing industry?
Well, that has been a very important issue, and this one here is answered by the Union Minister, Harsimrat Kaur Badal, who goes on to give details on the research and developmental projects for food processing industries and policy on data protection framework.
Amount of food processing which is being done in our country is extremely nascent, despite the fact that we are one of the largest producers of food in the world. We produce the maximum amount of milk, the second largest amount of fruit, vegetables and cereals. But while you got your figure of 2% right, which is the processing level of fruits and vegetables, overall we process almost only about 10%, whereas smaller countries produce process much more than that. One of the main reasons for that is the lack of infrastructure, as mentioned by the member, and which is why over the last 4 years, this ministry has focused on the creation of this infrastructure, not only on paper, but actually grounding of it. So to give certain examples, sir, this ministry had a mega food park scheme where 42 mega food parks had been sanctioned in 2008, and one park should take 2 years to complete. But from 2008 till 2014, in 6 years out of 42, only two got grounded. And in our 4 years, of the last 4 years, we have completed 13 more. So it is an increase of almost 550% of the operational parks. And the same thing in cold chains, which was started in 2010, sir, and only 37 out of the 97 of the cold chains were completed. We came and sanctioned 110 more, as well as completed 87 of them. So we have been working on creating infrastructure for this processing level to increase. You're right, out of the Kisan Sampada, Pradhan Mantri Kisan Sampada Yojana, which was the scheme was launched last year in May. It took time for the scheme guidelines to be made. It's a bouquet of 7 schemes where mega food park and cold chain is also part of it. We've added 3 new schemes to it.
Another question has been asked by Naresh Gujral of Shirmani Akali Dal, who asked the minister about the incentives offered by the central government to the units which help in reducing agriculture waste.
The Honorable Minister had stated that post-harvest, fruits and vegetables worth 1 lakh crore go waste. Thereafter, improvements have been made, and as the Minister has outlined, that they have many schemes which are helping in reducing this waste. My question, sir, is the incentives which are being offered by the central government today, how many units in the country have availed of those incentives? And also, if the minister has the figure of what is the total quantum of the amount which has been distributed to these units as subsidy.
Food Processing Minister Harsimrat Kaur Badal said that the centre is creating the necessary infrastructure and cold chain network to reduce food wastage and help farmers realise better value for their produce. Listen in.
The Honourable Member is absolutely right that one of the studies which was done by the Food Processing Ministry showed that almost 1 lakh crores worth of foodstuffs is wasted or it rots in our country, which is due to lack of proper infrastructure during harvest, transportation and storage. Which is why through our mega food park scheme for processing, through our cold chain scheme, through our mini food park, through our unit, through our backward forward linkage scheme, this entire 6,000 crores of Pradhan Mantri Kisan Sampada Yojana, which is going to leverage another 31,000 crores worth of investment in this sector, which is going to process agro-produce almost 334 million metric tons worth 1 lakh crores of rupees. So we are working on the grounding of all this. I can assure the House that out of all the ongoing projects of the 42 mega food parks, out of the 337 cold chains, as well as the 3 new schemes which are still ongoing, we are on target to ensure that they are grounded within the time period given. As you know, that setting up an industry is what takes time. plus because of the seasonality of the raw material of a food processing industry, it has a longer gestation period than all the others. So the ministry has, like I said, that we have had an increase of by almost 550% on the grounding of our mega food parks, by 130% of our cold chains. And if we talk about the employment created, as well as the farmers benefited, as well as the agro produce which is processed or preserved, these figures have all gone up by tenfold by what it was right. 4 years ago. Right.
So that's all we have for you in this episode of Question Hour.
Well, we'll bring you more important questions and answers next week. Stay tuned to Rajya Sabha Television.